clock showing this hour, today marks the 76th anniversary of Japan's unconditional surrender in World War II. And during the war, Japan violated the international law by secretly establishing Unit 731 in northeastern Chinese city of Harbin, carrying out germ warfare and a large number of human experiments. New objects from the Unit 731's base have recently gone on display for the first time at the Museum of Evidence of War Crimes by Japanese Army, Unit 731. So today we are going to pay a visit of the museum and take a look at the pieces of evidence of Unit 731's crimes during the war. And also today joining me is Mr. Tang Kai. He's the guide of the museum and today he's going to bring us a rich tour of the exhibition. So Tang Kai,
非常非常非常感谢您加入我们今天的直播哈。那我们再往前走呢，就应该是您们的第一个展厅了，对不对？
对。那我们从文泽的第一部分了解一下这段历史的背景。好的，好的。日本是自明治维新以后走上了一条对外扩张的道路，他们企图称霸世界。然而呢，日本国土面积狭小，缺乏侵略扩张所需要的武器资源，因此就必须要研制出一种既高效成本又低廉的武器，细菌武器就成为了他们的重要选择。 So Gautas, we can see here some pictures showing the history. Well, since the Meiji Restoration in 1868, Japan had adopted a national policy of expansionism and started to strengthen its military power. Alongside with its aggressive unconditional policy, the ideology of enriching the country and strengthening military forces was also promoted vigorously in the country.
1931年，日本发动了九一八事变，全面地侵占了中国东北，这为日本发动细菌战提供了必要的前提条件。
Gotcha. As we all know, the events well in 1931, September 18th marked the beginning of the war, and that provided Japanese condition for them to launch the biological warfare in China.
1936年，日本。
So if we come to this part, we can see several well things on the wall. Tell us what are they?
1936年，日本政府是按照天皇的敕令，首先在中国东北地区组建了哈尔滨731和长春100两支细菌部队，随后呢又组建了北京1855、南京1644、广州8604、新加坡9420部队。
Cultures, not only Harbin, even not only northeastern region of China, Japan has launched several units like this kind of units in China's Beijing, Nanjing, and Guangzhou, and even in Singapore. That's indeed in Southeast Asia. So you can see, 甚至在北京、广州这样的大城市，他们都有建立这样的生物基地。是的，是的，在这张示意图中，您看到用白色所标志出来的部分，就是当时日本各细菌战部队及其支队的主要分布情况。 So if we take a look at the map. So every part with this kind of white label, as you can see, including Tianjin, Hebei, Shanxi, and Shandong. So every province with this kind of white label means that is where Japan has established this kind of unit in this region. Okay, so we can see lots of parts, including Shandong, Hebei, Jiangxi, across China indeed.
是的，可以说是遍布了群众。 1930年，有一个叫做石井四郎的军医，在日本军内极力的鼓吹细菌战，受到了当时日军高层的关注和赞同。在他们的支持之下，石井四郎就成立了细菌研究室。Gotcha.
So if you see, this is a picture of Shiro Ishii. Let's remember his name, and he is later the commander of Unit 731, and he's a doctor degree in medicine, and he's leading the unit which launched the biological warfare in China and even in Southeast Asia. So we can see Shijing Silang, and we will introduce him later. Here we can see Tang Kai introduce him. He first introduced this concept of viruses and received government
support. Yes, yes. At that time, Shijing Silang needed a large number of human beings to conduct experiments. For this, he asked the authorities to transfer the research center to
Gotcha. So Shiro Ishii, because he needed a large number of humans to do the test, that is why he asked to set this kind of center in China. And the first part is set in Central Harbin, and it's not where we're here now, but it's in Central Harbin City. It's already being destroyed, this part. 所以这个部分您刚才跟我介绍是在哈尔滨中心的城市。
对，是在咱们哈尔滨的市区中心位置，现在是。
明白，明白。
然后呢，在经过一系列的转化转变之后呢，石井四郎是将部队转移到了我们脚下的现在的哈尔滨平房地区。这张照片就是当时的一张航拍图。
Gotcha. So that's the original heart of Unit 731, if we take a look at this picture, and this is the bird's eye view of the Unit 731.所以这个就是我们当时看到实景的七三幺部队的一个状态，是吧？
对，这还是早期的，还在建设中的七三幺部队这张航拍图。
明白，明白。能不能给我们介绍介绍？比如说画面中最显眼的这个地方是什么？
最大的这个建筑就是七三幺部队的核心区域，叫做四方楼。当时七三幺部队呢，很多的细菌实验和人体实验都是在这里进行的。
Gotcha. So in the picture, you can see this is called the quadrilateral angle of the Unit 73. You can see this is a square shape.And that's the core center of the whole unit. Lots of laboratory and lots of tests were done here, right in this building. Okay. So how about our museum? I know because our museum is set in the relics.
我们现在陈列馆所在的位置就是在这一块空地之上。对，我们的陈列馆没有侵占遗址区的任何的建筑。
Okay. So the museum is right now in this ground and without using any part of the relics.And today we can still see the relics in behind the museum. 所以今天我们依然能在这个博物馆的后面能够看到这些遗址。
对的，我们现在有27处遗址。
Okay. Okay. So we move on. We are entering the second part of the exhibition, and it's called the Unit 73, the Japanese Biological Warfare Headquarters. Give us more details about that, Mr. Tang.
在这儿看到的就是七三幺部队的首任和末任的部队长石井四郎的一张简历表。
Gotcha.
对，我们现在看到这张照片是石井四郎大学毕业时候所拍摄的。
Gotcha. So this is Shiraishi, who is the commander of Unit 731, and that picture is taken when he was graduated from Kyoto Imperial University. He's a medicine doctor. 其实是有医学博士学位。
对，他是1927年获得的微生物学的博士学位。
Gotcha. So he got his doctor degree in 1927, and later.
1930年开始主持日本细菌战计划。
Wow, just 3 years later, he in charge of the biological strategy.
一共是15年的时间，一直到1945年日本战败，石井四郎是带着核心资料乘专机逃回了日本。
Gotcha. So during that 15 years, he all stayed in China and launched his biological warfare plan. 所以这十五年他一直在中国，是吗？
对的，对的。
Gotcha. So he retreated from Harbin in 1945 after Japanese surrender, and he brought all the details of the report back to Japan. Gotcha. So 我们可以看到这个人他在中国长达十五年的时间里一直在开展细菌战，一直在开展生物实验这样的研究。Sure issue.
好，接下来我们走到一片沙盘，来了解一下
七三幺
部队的营区建筑的
分布
情况。
Gotcha. So under our feet now, as you can see, that's the module of the camp of Unit 731. So what is the white line?
这一条白色的跑道就是七三幺部队的专用的飞机场。
Gotcha. So as you can see, this white line is the special runway for Unit 731's airport.So for their airplanes, 所以是专门为他们建设的一个。
是的，是的，没错。不仅有七三幺部队呢，不仅有自己专用的飞机场，他们还有一条专用的铁路线，在这里可以看得到。
Okay, so besides railway, the Unit 731 also has their own railway line. If we take a look over here, as you can see, the small gray line, that's the railway of Unit 731, specialized for their transportation work.So Mr. Tang, tell us about what kind of thing we are seeing now in this part.
在这儿我们看到的就是七三幺部队遗址区的核心的区域。
Gotcha.
中间的这个四方形的建筑就是我们刚刚在地图上看到的那个四方楼。
The quadrilateral angle.
对的，没错。中间的两个小型的建筑，左侧是7栋，右侧是8栋，是用来关押被实验者的特设监狱。
Oh my God! So as you can see, that's the module of the Unit 731's camp, and that's.Square part, that's the quadrilateral angle, and you can see beside in the middle of the quadrilateral angle is 2 prisons. That's for humans who were captured by them and gonna do some experiments. Okay.
这个特设监狱您可以看到，它是一个2层的建筑。
Mm-hmm.
这个一圈这个四方楼，它是一个3层的建筑。
Yes.
但是它像现在咱们民用住宅有5层楼那么高，也就是说呢，从四方楼之外是根本看不见中间的特设监狱。
So what is interesting here, as you can see, the design of the quadrilateral angle is the prison is only 2-story building. And if you take a look at the outside, it seems to be a 3-story building, but indeed it was taller than a 5-story building. That design will make sure that people cannot see the prison from the outside. 所以在外面人们是根本看不到这两座。
是的，是的，这个呢也是按照这个波兰的奥斯威辛集中营来进行设计的。
So that design is like the Auschwitz concentration camp in Poland. Okay, gotcha.
那在这里，我刚刚告诉你说，这是731部队的核心区域。
是的。
那可以猜一下，你可以猜一下他们的办公地点是在哪
？The chief. 他们的办公地点。Well, actually, I saw lots of pieces here. For example, you got laboratory part, you got several talks gas part, the office.How about this green one? 是这两个绿色的吗？
是的，是的，就是在这个沙盘上最显眼的就是这个绿色的建筑。
OK。
对，前边呢叫做一栋，当时呢部队长的办公室就设立在二楼最右手边的这两个窗户。
部队长的办公室，那就是石井四郎的办公室。
是的，是的。
So as we can see, well, that's the chief office building for the Unit 731, and Shiraishi is right. Well, got his business here in the second floor of the front one.
是的，是的。所以说，当年绝大多数关于细菌战的指令是都从这栋楼里传出来的。
Yes, so most of commands was given out from this building sent from Shiraishi. Sure. And how about that part, Mr. Tang? Because I saw some labels showing that which part is what, but that part without any signs.
是这样。现在呢，我们在这边看到，凡是用名牌所标志出来的建筑呢，是都我们都已经向它有效的保护起来，并且呢是对外开放的。您看到这一侧。没有标记出来的都是曾经被731部队在撤离的时候所毁掉
炸毁
对现在都已经不在
Gotcha, so as we can see what have labeled here is something we kept down and we already know what their function is but over there their large part of area has been exploded by Japanese army during their retreat in 1945 所以其实还是有很大一片目前我们是看不到了
对的对的
我们继续往这边走的时候 ，if we move on, can see something else. How about this part, Mr. Tang?
这个就是731部队队员休息和居住的地方，叫做东厢宿舍。
Oh, so it's their camp, the living area. Gotcha. So actually, how many soldiers these unit have during that time? 当时
731部队呢，士兵、士官、军属加起来一共是3497人。
So only 3,000 people.That's not much for a camp for military. So, as far as I can see, it's not too much. So, I think that for a military, 好像3000多人不算一个非常大型的军队。
是的，您别看它只有3000多人，但是在这3000多人里边，有将官3人，左官44人，卫官102人，再加上当时这是这3000多人里边，拥有博士学位的有50多人。
所以医学博士吗？是吧？
是的，对。
Gotcha. So although they don't have too much soldiers in number, but they indeed are kind of elite soldiers because some of them really got medicine doctor degree. About 50 of them got that degree. 所以可以看到他们确实是用了一个很高精尖端的这个知识储备来做这个生物实验这样。
虽然人数不是很多，但是他们都是医学精英，是学者。
Gotcha. Well, how could a medicine doctor do this kind of thing on human beings? It's really incredible.
在这个展柜里，你可以看到呢，这是我们找到731部队的老兵所回忆出的1944年的一份菜谱。
Menu 啊，
这个菜谱就现在看起来吃的都是非常奢侈的。
Really good. So as we can see, that's the menu provided by an old soldier of Unit 731 in 1944. And as you can see, we have their breakfast, their lunch, of course dinner, and they indeed enjoy very good dinner. For example, they have some.Fish, they have some fruits, eggs, especially during wartime. 特别在战争中啊，我觉得这个菜谱还是很难想象能这样实现。
是的，是的。至于为什么可以吃得这么好，我们再看看这一边。
好哎。So if we move on to the right side, you can see something else.
1940年以后，731部队每年的军费超过了1000万日元。当时整个日本关东军的总经费才2000万日元，731部队相当于占到了他们的一半。
Gotcha. So.We can see, well, the military got really rich fund. Well, for example, after 1940, the annual military spending was more than 10 million Japanese yen, and they obtained additional funding of about 50,000 to 1 million yen for specific or special research projects. But it's really need to mention here, for the whole military here, for Japanese military in northeast China, it's called Kwanzong military, right? So they got about 20 million yen as their funds. So it's only double the military of Unit 731.Really too much. But how about this video, Mr. Tang? I have been catching up with this video.
这是七三幺部队的原队员，叫做沟原俊美。现在你看到这个视频，就是他对于七三幺部队经费所做出的一些证言。
Coach Charles, so that's the interview from an original soldier from Unit 731, and his name is Toshimi Mizufuchi, and he's talking about their funds used in Unit 731. So he's got an interview from your staff, 所以他在接受你们的一个采访，是吗？
对的，是的。现在我们在731部队原队员证言的视频呢，我们现在一共是有400多个小时。
So the museum have around 400 hours of interviews given from the original soldiers from Unit 731. So indeed, there are some soldiers they're willing to come out to speak about the history. 所以其实还有一部分军官他们是愿意出来来讲解这段历史的。
是的，是的，现在还有很多的这个731部队原队员是愿意配合我们的工作，表现出当年的一些忏悔。
Confession, Gautam.And if we take a look at those pictures, it's very interesting. As you can see, they're showing the camp of the Unit 73. And they are also enjoying some casual time, if I can see that. For example, they're seeing some sports meeting. And they also have some drama.所以我们可以看到，其实他们当时是在享受一个很正常的生活。
是的，因为这个地方当年叫做伪满洲国，对，是日本人的占领军，所以说对他们也是比较不仅仅是为了作战，对他们也是很享受当下的生活。
所以确实可以看到，就是说，那其实，在这3000多您刚才告诉我的这些人群中，还有一部分是只是家属吗？
对，有军属。
So because Harbin has been occupied during that time by Japan.So the military is enjoying a normal daily life. They can even brought their family members here. So now we can see some poison gas masks stand for the wall. 所以这边是一些可以看到的这个防毒面具了。
对，这个是当年731部队队员曾经使用过的防毒面具。
这个会具体到比如说哪一场实验或者是？
这个没有。
高超，所以你们是怎么能拿到这些防毒面具？
这个都是我们在这个征集文物的过程中，然后附近的居民手里征集来的。
So some local people provide you these kind of relics.
对，包括这些文物，您看到这些，军液的瓶，还有上面的实景式滤水器。
Oh, this is a filter. As you can see, that's designed by Roshimichi, right? 所以是石井四郎来设计的。
对，这个是石井四郎的一项研制。他们每次呢，就是这个白色的罐子里边会有六个水滤芯，然后野外的湖水或者是河水从上面倒进去。经过水滤芯的过滤之后，沿下方这个小水龙头放出来就可以饮用了。
Wow.
这个就是大大的解决了士兵在战场上的饮用水的需求。
But I've got this question is now why? Because they're doing some biological research. Why they need some purification equipment to bring in pure water? 就是很奇怪，他们在做这个生物或者人体实验研究，为什么会需要这样的滤水器呢？
对啊，你刚刚也说到了，七三幺部队也在做一些生物上的研究，这个就是其中的一项。他们不仅仅是为了研究这个细菌怎么去杀人，他们同时也要帮助自己的军队在战场上得到更大的权利，
就更健康的饮用水。
对，饮用水是一方面，包括食物也是。
So Unit 731 is also providing pure water for the Japanese soldiers in the front line. 所以他们同时还在做一些化学实验，为前方的日本士兵来提供更纯净的水源。
是的，没错。包括一会儿我们刚刚在后方还可以看到这个冻伤实验，也都是为了日本的士兵服务的。
这怎么讲？为什么冻伤实验会被用？
是因为这样，这个日本的士兵啊，在战场上经常发生这种冻伤。冻伤之后就
Because it's very cold here in Northeast China.
对啊，因为在我们中国东北真的很冷很冷。然后他们经常冻伤之后呢，如果解冻方式不当，这个士兵就属于减员，他不能再作战了。七三幺部队就收到了一项命令，说研究怎么解决合理的解决冻伤，让日本的士兵可以在冬天更持久去作战。
So for Japanese soldiers, they're indeed doctors, but for Chinese people, they're kinds of people. So.Mr. Tang, tell us what is it here? 我看到一些资料啊，这些统计，那么这些指的是什么呢？
当时的七三幺部队沿着中苏边境，一共是建立了5个分支机构。你现在看到就是林口支队。
高超，
这是当年的一些遗址和队员合影的照片。
高超 ，so the Unit 731 is also established some detachment across China and even in the border of China and Soviet Union. So here is the pictures of those soldiers.所以像他们这样的一支支队会有多大的规模？会有多少人？
100-200人左右。
Around 100 to 200 people.
是的，是的。
高超。Okay. So if we move on, we're going to which part?
我们接着到二层继续参观。
好的。So what we could have on the second floor?所以在二层我们能看到什么样的
展览？在二层呢，就是我们展厅的第三部分，展示出的就是G31部队的核心罪证——人体实验。
Gotcha. So if we take the elevator, we are going to this free part of the exhibition. It's called the core part of the research of Unit 731. So how did you get the material of the human experimentation part? 所以你们这些人体实验的，比如说。本物或者是罪证是从哪里能发掘到和找到的？
主要呢是三个方面，第一是从附近的居民手里征集而来，第二呢会有一些当年西藏部队撤离的时候，有一些文件存在废墟之下呀，或者是就是没有及时的带走。第三就是我们找到的西藏部队的老兵，就是到了日本，把一些文件和档案和一些资料带到了中国。
So this is the third part of the exhibition. That's the core part of your museum.He's talking about human experiments.
在介绍人体实验之前，我们先来了解一下细菌研究。G31部队呢，根据细菌武器研制的需要，成立了细菌研究部。部下设班，每个班是由负责人的姓氏来进行命名。
Well, that's interesting. As we can see, let's get to know first about the germ studies of the Unit 73. And if you take a look up here.They go the department of germ study and they go different part, but every part is named after the leader's family name. So this is very interesting. Its every class is using this leader's
family
name. 姓氏，对的，
对。
它没有直接说我到底研究的是什么。
对。
但您们在后面其实标注了，比如说这个所谓的草味班，它研究的是药理；所谓的田部班研究伤寒。那为什么当时要以这个长官的姓氏来命名？
是为了保密，仅仅就是为了保密。当时G31部队的这个石井次郎还下达了一项命令，所有队员之间不得交流工作的内容，都是为了要保密。
Gotcha. So to keep their work secretly, and they need to make sure that everyone do not know each other what are they studying on. So they name their department use their family name. But as we can see here, we can see they're studying several diseases like plague, cholera, as well as freezing. Oh yeah, here we have a major list.
在这看到就是731部队细菌实验的主要类型一览表。
Gotcha. So as we can see, they have studied in typhoid, cholera, plague, anthrax. It's really lots of disease. Around 29 kinds of.
是的，29种。在这张展板上可以看到，一共有29种。
So we even have their leader's name, right?
这脚下的我们复原的是一片场景，复原的是731部队的黄鼠饲养坑。我们先来看一个黄鼠的标本。
说我先看。
这是咱们东北地区特有的一种老鼠，它呢比普通的老鼠个头要大，黄色，眼睛也特别大。
Okay, so that's a ground squirrel living in northeast China. It's much bigger than normal rats, and it's a special kind of living in northeast China.Why is it special? 它为什么会被饲养来研究呢？
它和普通的老鼠相比，普通老鼠注射鼠疫之后1到2天就会死亡，它可以存活1周左右的时间。
Wow! So the Unit 731 is trying to inject the rats, the plague virus, and normal rats is going to die in 1 to 2 days. However, this kind of ground squirrel could live at least 1 week. So that is why they use this kind of animal research.
731部队就是利用它存活时间长这个特性，然后大量的繁衍鼠疫跳蚤。
Gotcha. So the unit using this kind of specialized rats and to recopulate this kind of disease. So how about Obama's instead under our feet?
在我们脚下看到的就是731部队黄鼠饲养坑的复原场景。复原的依据来自于前方第三张照片。
Gotcha. So what we can see.Well, under our feet is the old gray ground squirrel, and that's according to the real picture of the scene of the Unit 731.
当年G31部队一共是建立了96个黄鼠饲养坑，每一个长宽各1米，深0.8米。
Well, so the Unit 731 has established around 96 ground squirrel cave, and to raise this kind of ground squirrel for research. 所以他们 对这些蝗虫进行感染之后，它就将它们放出去，就是说对人体再进行感染。
它是这样。他是用这个感染了鼠疫的蝗鼠来饲养跳蚤，最后把跳蚤放出去。
Gotcha. OK. So here, if we take a look at the picture, what we can see here?
这个边看到的就是当时基层部队不仅饲养了蝗鼠，还饲养了很多大型的动物，比如说牛、马、羊、骆驼等等。无论是哪一种动物呢，实验结束之后都会形成一份这样的动物实验报告书，这个是原著。
So this is the original piece of the report of the animal test launched by Unit 731. So as you can see, that's the original piece.
这个是我们能看到的动物实验的原件哈。
对。
So earlier, as Mr. Tang mentioned, well, the Unit 731 has raised lots of animals. Besides rats, they also raised the rabbit, squirrel, house, and also donkey and cattle and for research.And they're gonna have one kind of report, and after that, so we have this original piece. It's really precious. And how about those pictures?
照片中这个人就是731部队动物饲养班的班长石井三男。
Ah, his name is quite like Shiraishi.
是的，他是石井四郎的三哥，毕业于日本兽医大学，在731部队呢，就是负责动物饲养班。
So he's the elder brother of Shiraishi, and he also works for Unit 731.
那这个不仅是三哥，731部队班。部队长石井四郎的二哥也在731部队，负责特赦监狱。
Gotcha. So another brother of Shiraishi also works in Unit 731, and he is in charge of the prisons. It's really well. The whole family is doing that kind of thing. 就整个家都在做这样的一件事情。
是的，是的，
是的。But how about his? 我知道您提起到过他的大哥，那是在战场上牺牲了。
对，他的大哥石井彪雄是在中日战争之前的任何战争就已经战死了。
So the first child of Shiraishi's family has died in the war. So now we are entering another part. Tell us what we can see here, Mr. Tang.
接下来我们看到的就是731部队人体实验报告书。
So what we can see here, that's the human test report. So if we go closer to see clearly, 这边我们能看到的是人体实验报告。
对，现在这个是封面页。
That's the coverage.The report of Q.
接下来我们看到就是它的内页。
OK.
在上面我们可以看到这些个人形，每一个人形就代表一条生命。
But OK, so if we can take a look at the picture, you can see a human-shaped drawing. But Tom told me that's because that is one life indeed. But as far as I can see, it's not without gender, without hair, without name. 但我能看到在图像上他们是一模一样的呀，就没有任何。也没有头发，也没有分性别，这是为什么？
是的，这个所有的被实验者来到731部队之后失去姓名，所有的被实验者都被编上了这样的编号，就在他们的耳旁。
Gotcha.
对，他们统称叫做为马路大。马路大是一句日语，翻译成中文就是剥了皮的木头的意思。可以看出，当年日本人是根本就没有把他们当作人来看待。
Oh my God! So all the humans who were brought into the prison, and they lost their names.And they only have this kind of number to show their identity. And they were called Maruta in Japanese. Maruta is kind of Japanese word which means a wood without skin. So it's really unbelievable.
在图中我们可以看到有非常多彩色的部分。这就是人体在感染了某种细菌之后身体发生变化的情况。
Gotcha. So if we take a look at the picture, we can see that some part of the human body is in...Some color, for example, in red, that means this part of the human has already been infected by some kind of disease.
由于这个当年的彩色照相技术并不是很发达，所以说呢，这些图像是由731部队从日本请来的画师在解剖的现场一笔一笔画上去。
So they look at the bodies and draw it on the paper. So because of the technology of photography at that time, and all these pictures were drawn by Japanese.Painters and without any photographers, and they draw the picture at the scene of the body. Okay, really. Yes. So as we can see, there's so many copies of the reports of the human experiments. So these are all the evidence we've preserved.
对的，对的。我们下方有中文的对照翻译。
好的。All these are human.Experiments report， 所以所有的这些都是人体实验的报告书。
在这看到就是 G 报告，这是鼻疽菌。
Okay, so that's my question. So later I won't ask, we can see the report of Q, the report of G. So that means Gandrin. 是鼻菊菌是吗？
对，是的，是鼻菊菌。
OK。
对，这个是它的封面页的影印件，然后旁边是我们的翻译稿。
That's the coverage and that's the Chinese translation part. So what inside about the report? 所以这个报告里面我们能看到它讲了些什么？
对，封面页，然后接下来我们看到就是内页，在这儿你看到这是数据。
So that's the original part. This is copy one made by the Unit 731. 这个是当时731部队自己根据人体实验做的记录，对不对？
对，但是呢，它的正常的话，它应该是日本的，对吧？
对。
但是我们现在看到这是英文。
对。
这是二战结束之后，然后美国和日本做了一系列的交易，美国拿到了这些人体实验报告书。我们现在看到就是美国的英文原件，英文
件。Oh, gotcha. So, well, we know that kind of history studied by the museum is after the World War II, after Japan's surrender, and the kind of secret deal between Japan and the United States, and they ask for the pardon of the war, so they use this kind of document to exchange. So that is why we can see this all in English translation, because that's the United States part. So also I can find that this part is saved in the Library of Congress.
对，它现在就是藏在美国华盛顿的国会图书馆。
所以可以看到，就是刚才唐老师也讲到，为什么这个其实就是731部队当年做人体实验产生的这样的一样的报告。那么本身它应该是日文的，但是因为当时日美之间达成了这样的一个，相当于是肮脏的交易吧。然后现在我们能看到的已经是英文翻译版了。那么这一版是被存在美国的华盛顿图书馆。So what we can see here inside, I can clearly see well, lawn, for example, and.
这个就是731部队在做人体实验的时候用显微镜观察之后画师所手绘出来的一些切片的一个图。
Gotcha. So using their microscope and after some body parts has been infected and they're gonna draw it.
这样的图再配合着旁边的解释说明，可以说是所有的数据清晰明了。
It's quite a clear report, but instead it's being done on human being.所以可以看到是各种非常详实的这样一个人体实验的报告哈。那我刚才看到咱们有这个 report of Q, what that stands for, 这个是什么意思？
它分别代表的是菌种的不同。
嗯、
对 ，Q 报告鼠疫菌 ，G 报告鼻疽菌，还有 A 报告炭疽菌。
Okay, so report Q stands for plague, and report G stands for gangrene, and report A stands for anthrax. 所以可以看到他们当时都是绝密，所以用的是各个。这样的一种缩写字母来代替的，但今天我们都能够知道它们分别代表的
是
哪些病菌。So I got another question, Mr. Tang. Why they use anthrax to infected people? 为什么当时在战场上他们会觉得炭疽菌或者鼻疽菌会是一个感染或者是有效的生物武器？
这个都是731部队这么多年他所苦心研究出来的。
嗯嗯，I know they're gonna be infected some limbs of human beings, 所以他会把人体的某些四肢或者什么给这个感染之后就会坏损这样子。
对，他们通过一次次的实验，然后去观察。对，您看到在这边就是731部队1943年在吉林农安进行一次实验的数据。
Oh my God, so that's all Chinese people in Jilin.
对。
So as you can see, this list is about the.Human being who being tested in their experimentation and is showing the age and the gender of the human beings. For example, the smallest one, as far as I can see, is only 3 years old. 所以我们在这儿能看到这张表上的 list is showing the human being who has been tested in the experiments. 所以我们可以看到在这张表上是当时在吉林被。做实验的老百姓的这个信息，所以在左侧第三列，
这是其中的一部分。这第三列的数字，这就是被实验者的年龄分布情况。
It's showing their age. The smallest one is only 3 years old.
这张表格上可以看到，年龄最小的是三岁。
Yes. And also the gender, they have some women, some men.And also, if we move forward, we can see that's the disease they have been infected. So, 这边是他们感染的症状、症病症，对不对？
对对对，病变的形式。然后
For example, plague. And the last part is?
感染的位置。
Is the body part which have been infected. Well, I have been noticing this video for a long time because we can see that our curator, Xin Chengming, he's on the screen. But tell us about the story. What is the video about?
这个视频是拍摄在2015年。可以看到这个是731部队的一名活体解剖技师叫做大川福松。
Gotcha. So this is Fukuki Mochi and he's a doctor and also a who used to infected people in Unit 731.
在这个展柜中可以看到这有一把军刀。军刀的主人就是我们刚刚看到那个大川福松。
So if we take a look at the box, it's showing a sword. The sword used to belong to Mr. Well, Kakua Fukumatsu.
那石井四郎为了表彰大川福松在活体解剖出做出的突出表现，将自己的佩刀亲赠给了他。日本战败的时候，他将这把军刀是秘密的藏了起来。
So the sword is given by Shiro Ishii as a compliment of these soldiers' achievements during the war, especially during his contributions in the Unit 731. So the sword is as a reward.
那我管这个工作人员经过多年的努力，在2017年将这把军刀带到中国展示于此。
Gotcha. So as we can see on the screen, is the curator of the museum. 这是其实是我们的馆长金成民先生哈，他亲自到2014年去了日本，然后跟这个老兵有一个讨论，然后将这个军刀带了回来。
现在您看到就是他向我们赠予这把军刀的过程。
Gotcha. So that kind of sign is showing that he's kind of confession for what he have done in China. 所以这个是否能看出这样的老兵他其实对自己当时的
是的，
所为还是
对他做出了一些忏悔，然后也愿意主动的将这些珍贵的一些东西交给我。
对，来到我们的博物馆作为一项陈列的文物或者是罪证哈。
在这边这个展柜里看到就是731部队队员在做人体实验的时候所使用到的一些器具。
Oh my god, so this is the tools the soldiers of Unit 731 used during their tests.
这个你看到的就是他们在做人体实验的时候悬挂内脏时候用到的解剖挂架。
So is that human 内是人体内脏？
对，是的，是的。
Oh my god. So this shaft is used to hunt humans' liver, for example, hearts, for example.During their test, it's really cruel.
然后他旁边看到就是截骨锯。
Oh, that tool is used for cut bones because the bones is quite strong. 所以就是骨骼还是有一定的强度的。
是的，是的，您可以看到这个工具非常的粗壮。
Oh my goodness. So, as we can see here, we can see some other leaders of the unit, right?
是的，是的，这是就是除了大川福松731部队的其他的一些解剖技师的照片。
Okay.
这也只是其中的一部分。
Okay, so these are the some autonomy technician of Unit 731. For example, we have Kozo Okumazo and Tachimura Yashikawa. These are other autonomy technicians.In Unit 731. Oh, we also even have their testimonies. So, 这边是有他们的供词的，是吗？
是的，是的。
所以这个是供词原件，相当于是。
对，这也是原件的。
Oh, that's the copy of a confession made by the man named Tamura Yoshio about the vivisection conducted by the employees of Unit 731. That's really precious.所以有这样的证据，其实我们觉得还是非常的强有力度的。
是。
对。So also we can see on the wall there's some stories about the story happened in the Unit 731, right?
这个是日本的一个作家叫做森村诚一，他写的一部文学作品叫做《恶魔的宝石》，他是呢日本国内比较早期的接触731部队的队员，并且敢于揭露他们这些事实的一个人。当然呢，这也只是一部文学作品。
So on the wall, we can see some part of stories which has extracted from a story called Devil's Gluttony, well, made by a Japanese writer. And it's talking about the true story happening in Unit 731. For example, they dissected a pregnant woman, and they also dissected a young boy. So you can see they were able to dissect some pregnant women.和非常年轻的孩子们。
对，这也就是我们在序厅那个位置所写的五个大字：犯人类暴行。
Okay. So what we can see here is the clearly part of the report. 所以这边我们可以看到更加清晰的刚才我们看到的那个人体实验的报告哈。So Mr. As you mentioned, the number means their name, 对吧？就是数字。
对，这是第178号马路大第十天身体发生变化的反应。
真的是很残酷 ，It's really cruel. Without any name, and they got their numbers 178, and the days means they have been infected for 10 days. It's really cruel. As you mentioned, well, we have so many color on their body, right? Besides red, 所以刚才我们在幻灯片上只看到一些红色，其实在这里面我们能看到很多别的颜色，
有蓝色，有黄色，可以看到他们用的肺部的感染。
For example, we have red, yellow, and blue. So every part with the color means this part has been infected. 所以每一个有颜色的部位都是被感染的。
对。
Okay. That's the true evidence of what we have done in China.
这个真的确实是他们实实在在在中国做的事情，他们自己做的研究，他们自己做的报告。
对。
OK。
在前面这个走廊里，我们就可以看到西班牙部队三座焚尸炉的照片。
OK。So here we're gonna see some photos of incinerator made by Unit 731.
这三张照片是西班牙部队的三座焚尸炉。1945年的时候，西班牙部队是将这一座焚尸炉进行了炸毁，另外两座我们现在保存完好。
Gotcha. So we have this incinerator made by Unit 731, and the third one is already being exploded by the Unit 731 during their retreat, and the first one, second one have been capped. How tall is it? 这个焚尸炉大概有多高？我们有一个大概的。
十米以上。
It's around about 10 meters. Okay.So if we come from here, if we take a look on the right side,
这个展柜里看到就是七三幺部队在建造锅炉房和焚尸炉的时候所使用到的耐火砖。
So it's the true bricks, 所以是当时真实留下来的。
是的，这都是我们采集来的原件。
Okay, so that's the bricks the Unit 731 used when building an incinerator. That's the relics, well, the stuff of the museum found around these relics.就这个耐火砖，他们是在中国制造的，
是的，是的，这是在中国河北生产。
Okay, it's been made in Hebei province. So now we are entering another part of the museum. It's very special, and we can see a kind of drum here. So tell us what is it?
这个是我们复原的731部队的三个野外实验场之一的安达野外实验场。
Okay, this is Anda field test. But what are the? I saw the pictures.
是的，我们可以看一下墙面上这个壁画。
Okay.
他们就是将被实验者捆绑在已经固定好的十字架上，然后给被实验者的头部戴一个金属盔，躯干部位是用铁板装的。
Oh my god! So as we can see, the people were tied on this kind of wooden cross, and they are wearing a kind of metal hat, and also wearing a kind of metal protection.Why they need wear this kind of protection? 为什么他们要穿这样子的保护衣呢？
是因为这样，他们在做实验的时候，就是用飞机会投下一枚陶瓷制的细菌炸弹，炸弹爆炸开来，弹片会冲击这些被实验者的身体。为了不致使他们当场毙命，所以说呢，会给他们保护起来，要害部位都是要保护起来。
Gotcha. So well, what kind of field test the Unit 731 is going to do is they're gonna use a plane.And brought a bomb, and they're gonna drop the bomb from the sky and on the ground. So after the bomb exploded, they're gonna hurt the human beings here being tested. And in case they would die at the first, they would be protected at their key part of the body, so that they could be put into research later. It really feels sad for me to do this kind of translation.
所以说他们其实是被保护起来，为了关键的要害部位不被伤害到。
对，如果当场毙命的话，就没有任何实验价值。
Oh my god! So as you can see, this kind of wooden cross is where the human being tied, and they are doing some field test. But Mr. Tang, how about the video about it? What is the video talking about?
这个视频中看到，就是我们根据当时 这个一个真实的场景来进行复原嘛。
嗯，
这个是有一个被实验者的绳子在实验的时候松开，他没有选择独自逃跑，他解开了所有人的绳子，大家一起四散逃开。但由于这个安达野外实验场是一块非常宽阔的平原地带，是根本无处躲藏，731部队队员驾驶的卡车将他们全部碾压致死。
Oh my goodness, so the story is about, well, one of the people who has been tested has escaped from the test, but he tried to save all his partners, he tried to save them. As you can see, they all escaped, but however, all of them have been crushed to die by the cars of the Unit 731.
然后他们实在太残忍了，就是他们逃走之后还要开车一个一个撞死。
对，
这个是为什么呢？就是
为了保密，他不想让任何一个人逃出他们的控制。
To keep all the tests in secret, they kill all the people.
所以为了将他们的实验保密，他们将所有参与实验者，如果他们侥幸逃出去的话，他们就把他们一一杀死。
So here is another scene we can see in the exhibition.
在这儿看到就是我刚刚提到的冻伤实验
，freezing test. Okay.
他们就是将这些被实验者捆绑在这些固定好的这些位置，
okay.
然后任其发生冻伤。
Okay. Okay. So it's all Chinese people, right? Local people.
所以其实被他们实验，他们是为自己的日本士兵做这个实验，
对啊、
但是被实验全部是中国人。
对的，对的。他们就是将冻伤形成之后，然后再研究怎么去解决冻伤。
Okay, so the Unit 731 want to solve the Japanese soldiers' freezing problem, and they use Chinese people and local residents to do tests, and they tie them, as you can see on the cross, and to make them get freezing, and later they observe it and they try to treat them. It's really.Kind of things really harsh.
就可以看到他为了治愈自己的士兵男，中国人来做实验。
Okay, how about this part?
在这儿看到的就是731部队毒气实验的场景。他们将被实验者推到这个密闭的玻璃柜里，从上方施以不同程度的毒气。
Okay, so now we are seeing the scene of poison gas experiment.And they put the human being into this kind of glass box and try to inject well poison gas into the box. And they later observe their reactions, right? So what about this scene? What we can see here?
在这个场景里看到这个被实验的，他是一对来自苏这个香港保育院的一对苏联的母女。
Oh my god. So not only Chinese also.
对，不仅仅是中国人的。这个是我们根据当时731部队的队员的证言来进行还原的，这些事情是按照真实的事件所复原的。
Okay, so these scenes come from a testimony of a soldier from Unit 731 and showing that a woman and her daughter come from Soviet Union and they're being used in gas prison test.
在做实验的时候731部队队员可以看到在外边用秒表纸笔相机进行效果观察，直到被实验者被毒死为止。
It's really can't believe that it's really cold blood. 太冷血了，这种感觉。
没错，我们再往左边看。
OK。
这个是731部队的专用的马匹，日本关东军专用的马匹一个模型。
Okay.
它的头部戴的就是马专用的防毒面具。
Oh, the mask. So it's really ironic here because you can see they use people to do the test and they protect their horse.所以日本的军马都可以得到保护。
对啊，我们可以看到这一个场景，这是我们可以做出来的一个效果。他们把自己的军马武装到了牙齿，却对我们活生生的人做人体实验。
It's too bad.
前方展柜中看到的就是更多的731部队队员在野外进行施毒和防毒演练时，保护自身所用到的防毒面具。
So that's the poison mask the soldiers of Unit 731 used in their test.
So how many do we have here? 我们大概有多少？
几百件。
We have hundreds of them. So where did you get them? 你是怎么？
这都是我们在附近的居民手里征集来的。
Gotcha. And also, I saw a picture here. That's the true scene, right?
对，这个就是他们在做毒气实验的时候的照片。
真实的场景，可以看到日本。士兵们戴着这样的
放毒面具。They're wearing this kind of, well, gas protection mask in the field lab. And also we can see some testimony given by one of the leaders called Yatura Ueda on poisoning the Marusa by poison gas. So they all call the human Marusa. 他们在实验记录中甚至都叫这些人马路大。
是的，是的，马路大。
They never treat them as human, 就没有当他们当同类来对待。
是的，就是一个木头。
They're living people, they can sleep, they can love, they can screen, but why they treat them as wood? 这个真的难以想象，因为在实验中人们一定会叫喊，因为痛苦啊，会怎么可以把他们当做木头呢？真的是难以想象。So if we calm down, we are entering another part of the exhibition. And Mr. Tang Kai, what we are going to see here.
下面我们来到这个展厅，讲述的就是这些被实验者究竟是什么人，
okay.
就是所谓的这些被实验者的马路大，他们到底都是些什么样的人
？So who are they? So basic processing.
可以看到，从抓捕、审讯到后方的押送、交接，各个环节是非常的缜密的。
Okay, so they have a strict procedures to transfer and to find these people who could be tested. So how did they get these people? 他们到底是怎么来抓到他们这些实验者的？
大部分的这些被实验者当年都是一些反满抗日志士、国际情报组织人员，战俘也是占到一定的比重。
Gotcha. So most of people who have been tested in Unit 731, they are people who fight against the Japanese army and some agents, and also some, well, some soldiers who have been catched in the war. Well, as you can see, this is a picture of one of the agents, right? 所以这个是一个受害者的照片，是吗？
对，这个是受害者是有照片的，你可以看到这下边侧面、正面的照片都有。
Why we have this kind of photo? 这个照片为什么会有侧面和正面？是从731的档案中获得。
对的，对的，所有他们要求的数据，包括这些资料和档案，要非常的完整。
Gotcha. And we have another photo of Mr. Li Houbin. He's another victim of the Unit 731. 所以这位也是一个另外一位受害者，是吗？
是的，是的，他是被转送到从这个日本，从这个咱们边境虎林这个位置，然后转送到731部队。
OK。那他们是怎么抓到他的呢？就等于说，当时他们会有一专门的人去审。
对，这个731部队的这个并不是他一支部队完成，他由日本各级的军警县特共同来完成。
OK。
从抓捕，包括有宪兵队，包括有这些特务机构，他们负责抓捕，然后再移送到731部队，由731部队就是所谓的进行实验。
Understood. So the whole process is under the help of all the detachment of the Japanese military, and they help to catch the normal people and local residents, and then bring them to Unit 731 and to do the test. And also, we can see some testimonies. So who are they in the video?
这个都是其他部队的人员。然后我们在这是做了一个场景，你可以拿起一个电话，就可以听到他的声音。就是对应的每一个人，对的。
So if we pick up the phone, we can hear what they say. Oh, they're saying Japanese.
这个是731部队运输班的队员，叫做岳定南。
Gotcha. So this is one of the soldiers. This is one of the soldiers of the Unit 731, and he's for the transfer part.And he's talking Japanese and saying about his work in the Unit 731. He's talking about how they transfer people to the unit. And how about the second one? I saw on his face is a kind of regretful. 我可以看到第二个人，他其实表情还是非常痛苦的。他是
是的，是的。
Yoshio Tachiya, what his job? 他当时是做什么的呢？
这都是其他部队员队员。这个是当时的一个宪兵，就是所谓的负责抓捕人的。
Okay. Then take them in the car. As I saw what he said here.
这个人曾经到中国进行过谢罪，就是他曾经抓捕了一个，这个当时的一个共产党员。
哦，
抓捕一个共产党员，然后把他送到了731部队。这名共产党员呢，就是最终是在这里牺牲了。他向这名共产党员的家属进行了跪拜谢罪。
So this one is also one part of soldiers of Unit 731, and he had caught a Communist Party member and brought him into the Unit 731, and that member had sacrificed his life here, and he has come to China and to express his regret for to the family members of it.
在这儿可以看到有一组红色的数字和下方不断闪动的名字，可以说呢，他们每跳动一次，代表着一条鲜活生命的消失。
So, the final part in the middle of the hall, we can see the numbers on the screen. That means the number of people who died in the Unit 731, and the total number now is around 1,400, right?
当时731部队，我们现在查到的有名有姓有档案的这些受害者，一共是1549。
So currently we have the names of around 1,500 victims' name, and as you can see, there are their names on the screen. 所以我们可以看到，在屏幕上有他们的名字哈。Finally, they have their names. 所以最终，在我们很多考古人员的努力下，这些。当时被抓的所谓的满陆大，但终于有了他们的名字，他们都是实实在在存在过的中国老百姓。So what? How about these colorful stripes?
这些是日本民间爱好和平的团体和当年日本人的遗孤，然后所敬献的一些千纸鹤和挽联，在另一侧可以看到挽联。
Gotcha. So these colorful stripes are given by some Japanese people, and they love peace and they come to pay tribute to.People who have died because of Unit 731, and of course we can see some confessions of the offsprings of Japanese people. On the stripe, we can see they're noting that one kind of friendship between China and Japan.
我们将现已查明的这1549个人的名字全部刻录在了展柜的上方。他们大多数是中国人，也有朝鲜人、蒙古人、苏联人。
So if we take a look above, we can see all the name of the 1,500 victims of the 731 unit, and that's all their names. Besides Chinese, we also have some people who come from Mongolia, who come from Democratic People's Republic of Korea, and some other countries.So, well, that's all for us at this hour, and today we have paid visit to the museum of Unit 731's relics, and of course we have learned the history of that part. Well, some experts believe that part is one of the darkest and one of the most violent part in the history of human civilization, because lots of human beings were used in biological tests.So it's really a sad moment for the history and also for us of Chinese people. I have talked with some of your visitors, Mr. Tang. 我曾经跟你们的一些参观者都有聊，甚至 I saw some people who bring their daughter and their son. They're very small, 有些九岁甚至八岁的孩子来这里参观。他们的父母告诉他们，我们希望他们能够铭记这段历史，然后更好的铭记历史，才能更好的知道我们中华民族当时所遭受的苦难。So after all, we need to know this history, we need to remember this history. I think that's the best way. We need to carry on and we need to safeguard peace. So that's all for us at this hour. We'll see you next time. 非常感谢您，陶老师，我们下次再会。
再会。